I run security software. Why do I still sometimes get infected? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a common question. I have virus protection always on and I have the Windows firewall enabled. Why do I still get infected with some Trojan horses? I've checked for updates every day, so I'm sure that I'm up to date. Most people believe that they're completely protected because they have an anti-malware program or additional security software. Unfortunately, that's just not how things work. The answer is partly the nature of the anti-malware software and partly the nature of the race. I use that term, the race, on purpose. Combating viruses is a four-way race. In the lead, unfortunately, are the malware writers, looking for vulnerabilities and writing malware to exploit them. Coming in second are the security software vendors, as they look for ways to detect and eradicate the new malware as it shows up. Next are the application and system software vendors who are looking to plug the security holes. Last place are folks like you and me, keeping our systems up to date with the latest updates to both our security software and the software that might have the vulnerabilities. Now, as you can see, virus writers are always in the lead. You and me, like I said, we're dead last. Hopefully it's close to a tight pack, but even so, we're last. As a result, the first answer boils down to simple bad luck. It's possible to be doing security as well as you can and still get infected if your anti-malware software has not yet been updated to detect a new threat, and your system or application software has not yet been patched to fix whatever vulnerability the virus exploits. All security software is the same, but different. I want to be clear, there is no best antivirus or security software. Almost all the name brands are good, but there isn't one that detects absolutely, positively everything. In other words, no matter what security software you run, it may miss something. Different packages may miss different things, but there's no single package you can count on to catch absolutely everything. So it's possible to get infected, even though your anti-malware tools are completely up to date. All malware is not created equal, which is why there are so many terms to describe the variations. Some exist merely to propagate. Others exist to do damage. Some exist to silently send spam. Still others start to blur the line between virus and spyware since they install monitoring or additional vulnerabilities on your system. Some travel by email. Others travel by downloading applications. Others can travel from unprotected computer to unprotected computer directly through the internet. No anti-malware tool can protect you from yourself. For example, if you open an email attachment that you don't recognize and run it, you may install a virus before your security software has a chance to act. When downloading a file, if you choose to ignore a warning that your security software or firewall displays, you're telling the software that you know better than it does what is or is not safe. Why is it like this? Well, it's hard to say. Ask 10 people and you'll probably get 10 or maybe 11 different answers. Hackers with too much free time, operating systems that aren't robust enough, success in the marketplace that makes for a bigger target, and more. Of late, there's more money to be made by infecting large numbers of machines with spam-sending bot software or malware that steals your login credentials to your bank or other important sites. It shouldn't be like this. But for whatever reason, it is like this and will be for the foreseeable future. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2175. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.